Peyton Mitchell. I play Scuttle in The Little Mermaid. We are having our show March 30th through April 2nd. That is this Thursday through Sunday. So come see our show. It's literally so amazing.
It's so fun, and I can't wait for you guys to see it.
Hello, I'm Ayana Ward.
And I'm Jace Kirby. Welcome to today's Summit View. Let's go to Jackson and find out the latest happenings here at Summit.
Hey guys, I'm Jackson Muller, and here's what's up at Summit. This Friday, Summit High School will hold its first Poetry Slam competition at lunch in the library. There will be prizes, and the top three winners will advance to the Middle Tennessee Teen Grand Slam Finals. Visit your library or see your English teacher for more information. That's what's happening here at Summit. Back to you guys.
Now, here's Mr. Jackson with today's Get Your Act Together.
Welcome to Get Your Act Together. I am your host, Mr. Jackson, coming to you today from Mr. Price's room, where I'm currently covering his personal finance class. Stay tuned today, because today we're all back in the ACT and we're doing a little bit of English practice.
Show you the world, shining, shimmering, splendid.
A whole new world, a dazzling place I never knew.
I'll chase them anywhere, there's time to spare. Let me share this whole new world with you.
Something that happens on the English section that doesn't really happen on any of the other sections, because none of the other sections really lend themselves to this occurrence. What happens is sometimes English, all in one paragraph, will just throw a boatload of questions at you all at once. And what I call that is question blitz. English will just straight up hit you with question blitz. And so what I do in question blitz is I don't assume that I need to do it in the order that it gave me, right? I put the questions in whatever order I want. Right? So there's going to be a question blitz on your task today, and I encourage you to answer them in whatever order makes the most sense to you and helps you do it the best. Sometimes getting the second or third question might help you answer the first one better. In that question blitz today, it doesn't also necessarily even cover the same topics, right? So like, for example, in today's question blitz, you're going to have redundancy, you're going to have punctuation, you're going to have transition words, and you're going to have verb tense all within the same paragraph, right? And we're going to talk about those when I come back to review the questions.
What's up, Summit? We're doing the ACT word of the day. We're at the basketball game. Yeah.
Yo.
What's up?
You gotta be a little bit more feisty over here if you're watching the game.
What does that mean?
It means aggressive, lively, or energetic.
Can you show me what that looks like?
Cut it. Them bricks is way too high, you need to cut it. Your price is way too high, you need to cut it. Cut it, 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 cut it. Them bricks is way too high, you need to cut it. Your price is way too high, you need to cut it. Running through bands on a regular,
cash.
Hitting my plug on the celly. Tell my sorry,
my bad.
I'ma skate off in a Rara. Key 36 by my side.
My side.
I'ma go bake me a pie. Key 45 by my side. You die. Blood.
Yeah.
All of my say cuz.
Yeah.
OT, I found me a plug.
Yeah.
I got it straight out the mug.
Yeah.
Keep it 100,
no
bugs.
No,
I'm feeling low with the
yeah.
Busting it down in the tub.
Cold.
Pay me my money in dubs.
Oh. Hey, sorry I'm not with the gimmicks.
Uh-uh.
How you play?
Hey.
I know every DJ but the academics.
What?
Train hit the floor and broke boys had a scrimmage.
Whoa.
You say you a robber, I'm saying.
I'm saying.
So why you ain't throwing my pants?
Glizzy
gang, we tell a band. Check it on boys who don't eat no ham.
Hey.
I'm cussy, hop out the band.
Yeah.
Spray you at two of your mans.
Yeah.
I'm going to DR in the morning.
DR.
My gotta go see a fam. These robbers, they not gonna ride.
Uh-uh.
Security not on your side.
Uh-uh.
They gotta know that they gon' slide.
No.
They gotta know that they gon' slide.
Oh.
You better keep one by your side.
Bye.
You better keep one by your side.
Bye, bye.
I just get a word to that guy.
No way.
They shoot in his eyes. We don't give a f, sir.
No fuck.
We don't give a f- you wear.
No fuck.
We don't bang. You're a real
back with the gang.
Cut it, 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 cut it. Them bricks is way too high, you need to cut it. Your price is way too high, you need to cut it. Cut it, 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 cut it. Them bricks is way too high, you need to cut it. Your price is way too high, you need to cut it.
Winning, bought a 911 with my trap money. A million up, but still ain't never touched my rap money.
Here's your question, Blitz. You got all four of them right here, back to back to back to back. Let's dive in. The high cost of importing cinchona bark, however, was expensive. Now, here's the problem with this. I can't even focus on this word choice question or this redundancy question, right? This conciseness question. I can't focus on it while we have this mess right here, personally. So I personally am gonna have to deal with 23 before I deal with 22. Let's try that. However, was expensive. Oh, look. However is still a transition word, but it's right here in the middle of the sentence. Anytime a transition word happens in the middle of the sentence like that, you've got to see whether a complete sentence comes before and after it or not. In this case, it doesn't. Afterward is just was expensive, right? And so that means that there can't be a semicolon, right? And it also means that you can't keep it how it is, because there's a separate rule where if you're going to put however in the middle of a sentence like that, it has to have commas on both sides, right? So the answer to that one is C. Now I'm at peace and can go back and answer number 22, right? So let's try that. The high cost of importing cinchona bark, however, was expensive. We can't change the fact that it says expensive here. Do you see it? So you don't need to say high cost, right? Because you've already said it's expensive, that's repetitive, right? So you just keep it simple. It's just importing. Importing cinchona bark, however, was expensive. Done, right? Let's go on to 24. Consequently, in the mid-1700s, English minister Edward Stone here we are again. I can't even think about whether consequently is the appropriate transition word here. I can't even consider it. Why? Because this mess sounds so bad. English minister had began, try again, had began doesn't exist in the English language, right? So, what we see here is we're in the past tense, right? Was. It was expensive and in the mid-1700s, so we need a past tense verb, right? Well, which one over here is in the past tense? That would be began. Now I can go back and do 24 and read the sentence properly. Watch. Consequently, in the mid-1700s, English minister Edward Stone began to seek a substitute. Okay. Is this next one a consequence of the first one? Did he go seek a substitute because it was expensive? He certainly did. Consequently is the correct answer. The answer is no change.
It is time for our prize drawings today. All winners come from successful submissions on Tuesday's task, and we'll get to choose from a whole variety of different types of unpicked up candies that I have here. I still have plenty left over. Those prizes can be picked up in my classroom, A114, on the math hallway, during lunch or immediately after school, or... ninth graders, I'll bring it to the other building if you'd like. Let's find out who won. For my ninth graders, it's Rowan Brown from Miss Veloz's homeroom and Gavin Duke from Coach Kirby's homeroom. Congratulations, Rowan and Gavin. 10th grade winners, Elodie Marshall from Miss Lewis's homeroom and Vincent Castillo from Coach Jordan's homeroom. Congratulations, Elodie and Vincent. Junior winners, Brady Gray from Coach Riker's homeroom and Adam Hazelwood from Mr. Chandler and Miss Miller's homeroom. Congratulations, Brady and Adam. And my 12th grade winners, Trevor Young from Mr. Hallbright and Ms. Ryan's homerooms, and Abby Lambert from Mr. Dinwiddie's homeroom. Congratulations, Trevor and Abby.
Thanks for tuning in today. I hope you have a marvelous weekend. I'll see you next week when we will be diving into the math and reading sections yet again.
Well, that's all for today.
See you back here tomorrow. Thanks for joining us.